old. Mm-hmm. I was here for a game between the Maple Leafs and the Blackhawks. And the clock at the time was not digitized like they are today. It was the round clock that counted down. It looked like the actual face of a clock. Mm-hmm. But what struck me the most in that hockey game was a fight that occurred. And I believe Pierre Pilote was playing defense for Chicago at the time, and he got into it with Eddie Shack. And at that time, they didn't have the separate penalty boxes.
Okay.
They would have this. All the players sat in the same box, and there was the gentleman that was in the penalty box. They used to call him the keeper of the cooler, and you always understood who it was. You could always recognize him because he wore this British racing cap that he had on, and it was beige, and he really stood out because he would be sitting between these mammoth hockey players. Mm. Well, Shaq and Pilote went at it on the ice. They get the penalties. They get thrown into the box for their 5-minute majors, and all of a sudden, they decide they want to continue it in the box.
Oh, come on.
Well, it got so confusing. Guys tried to get in through the door, and mm-hmm. they couldn't get in because of the confusion and the mayhem that was going on. All of a sudden, Frank Mahovlich comes skating over. He literally climbed over the glass.
No way.
And into the penalty box to separate the two guys. Took a huge chunk out of the glass with his skate. And we were about 8 rows up. Right on, in fact, it was on this side mm-hmm. and probably as close to the penalty box as we are right now. And I could, this giant, and Frank Mahovlich was a huge hockey player. And he climbs over the glass and splits these two guys up. And those are the kinds of memories that that I started to have. And I remember that when the Marlies, the Toronto Marlboro Juniors, were a feeder system for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Mm-hmm. Back in those days, the NHL teams actually owned the junior clubs, right. And they used to be feeder systems. Ron Ellis was playing, and he was one of the – even in the NHL, he was a terrific skater. But in junior, he completely dominated. Wayne Carlton, who went on to have a career not only in Toronto but in Boston as well. They used to call him Swoop because he was this massively tall, gangly hockey player who looked like he was floating on the ice as he was taking these long, graceful slides around. I remember Jerry Cheevers, mm-hmm. former Boston Bruins goaltender, a Boston great, a legend in Boston, playing for the Hamilton Red Wings. And they used to come in and play against the Marlies with the Red Wings, the St. Catharines TPTs, the Chicago Blackhawks farm system. It was, I mean, these memories just keep coming back to me, but it's such a pleasure to be in this building and to actually feel the ghosts of all those hockey players from the past.
Yeah, you know, it's a great point that you bring up. I mean, I was lucky enough to grow up in the Toronto area. I was lucky enough to come to games at Maple Leaf Gardens as a kid, and I grew up when, funny enough, Doug Gilmore and Wendell Clark were very prominent players in this city. So, you know, I've got some very fond memories of this building as well. Different stories, of course. Maybe not as amazing as your stories, not as colorful, but, you know, it's a great point. And I think being here in this building really speaks to a lot of the players on the ice. Even though we've got a mix from across the country, you know how Leafs fans are.
Oh,
they're
sure.
From coast to coast to coast. So some of the guys from Vancouver really appreciate playing on the ice just as much as the guys from Scarborough.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Now, you know, you talk about the Leaf team as I guess they could be declared Canada's team, especially in the West before expansion. I'll never forget when I was actually working in Calgary and covering and working with the Flames as the host of their hockey telecasts out there back in the early 80s. And the first time, the Flames had just come up from Atlanta. So the first time any team came to town, it was a special occasion. But especially when Toronto and Montreal came to town. When the Leafs and the Habs came to Calgary, it was something very, very special. Mm. And the first time that both of those teams came to Calgary, and they were still playing in the old Calgary Corral, which only housed 5,500 people, it's actually smaller than this building.
Huh.
The local police had to come out and set up a cordon to allow the players to make it from the dressing room as they exited the building to the bus to get back to the hotel, because there were so many people hanging around just wanting to get a piece of both the Habs and the Leafs as they finished their pregame skates.
Oh my goodness.
Their morning skates before the game.
That's incredible.
It was just so I mean, I know we're off the topic as far as today's proceedings are concerned, but hockey is in everybody's blood. It's part of the fabric of Canadian society, and to be part of this tournament, the Blind Hockey Tournament, and hockey in general,
we're so lucky. happy to be here, and we're getting you set for the Team Canada face-off battle as Canada East gets set to take on Canada West. Canada East donning in yellow jerseys, the red and gold emblem. Canada West in all black here as they get set to defend and to our roots.
A good or bad play, so I might have to mute my mic because that seems to be the thing that a lot of analysts have to do if you're between the benches. I'm not sure if there's going to be a whole lot of chirping going on, but I know some of the coaches can get pretty aggressive as well. So.
I think you should have shaved your head for this one as well.
No, I think I'll keep the hair for this one.
Warm-ups continue. Less than a minute to go before the opening face-off of this big matchup between Canada East and Canada West. I think the first goal of this game is going to be very, very important for whichever team scores.
Yeah, it could definitely be a momentum setter here in this game. It's certainly going to set the tone for the game, I think. You know, the opening select series game between Team Canada and Team USA, that was a tight game. Ended up being 3-1. It was basically 2-1 for the bulk of that game. I think we're going to have a very similarly close kind of game here where it could end up being one or two mistakes are the key difference. And, yeah, whichever team can get out in front, that mm-hmm. could end up proving to be the difference in the end.
Hello, everybody, and welcome once again to the 2019 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament here at Metamay Athletic Center, Ryerson University. We thank you once again for going out and supporting blind hockey.
Well, we appreciate everybody tuning in here this evening for this matchup as it's Canada East in the yellow taking on Canada West in the black. Starting goaltenders in this game, Joey Cabral takes the net for Canada East, for Canada West. None other than Edmonton's own Lorne Weber as he gets set to make his debut. Both of those players, a big part of the gold medal victory down in Pittsburgh. Jason Juha gets set to get out there for Canada West as he'll square off. I would anticipate him taking the opening draw. He'll be wearing number 91 here for the team in black.
Team West representing or protecting the goaltender to the right, and Team East to the left. They will not change ends throughout the course of this game. They maintain their positioning throughout the three periods, and the periods are 12 minutes each. Stop time.
And I want to apologize off the hop. We're experiencing some difficulties with our graphics at the moment, so unfortunately, no running clock, no score bug in this game. But hey, we've got a great looking image, and that's what counts most. As we get set for the opening puck drop here between Team Canada East and Team Canada West. Kelly Serbu, Jason Juha to take the opening faceoff. And we're underway. Team Canada West take early possession as they move the puck off the boards, and it's scooped up by Serbu. He dumps it down into the corner, down to our right. Tracked back where it's Alex Angus McKechnie behind the goal, trying to center it out front. That shot gets blocked. Alec Angus comes up with it. Serbu lets the shot fly, and that one goes wide of the post. Chopping after it, a couple players coming together, including Mark Bentz out there for Team West.
Of course, there's no hitting in blind hockey, but there will be contact. Sometimes it's just impossible to avoid.
Jason Juha takes the puck here for Team West. Tries to center it out front to Scott Roberts, but that one picked off. As Team Canada East try clear the zone, they get the puck across center ice. The West have it right back in the zone as Juha waiting for some support. Drops it, intended for Kiefer Jones, but that one gets picked off. Good defensive play by Simone Richard. Shot from Canada West, good block there by Wyatt Harvey as he sprawls out to get a piece of that shot from Martin Dufour.
That was going to the open corner on the left side, but Harvey managed to get his body in front of it.
Simone Richard dumps it from the wrong side of center ice. DeMontis races after it, but with double IHF rules in place, it's automatic icing.
Good start for both of these teams. They've each had opportunities early in this first period. A minute and a half in, the East has almost scored, and so has the West, so and they're skating very, very well. The ice looks very good tonight.
Well, the players love playing here. They always rave about the quality of the ice, and when you're a speedy team like both of these clubs, it should lend to good play. A good play there to keep the puck in the zone. Chula tries to track it. Jules Ouellette can't hold it in as Canada East get it out to center. Chula picks it up inside his own blue line. A couple of East players crashing down as here goes Chula into the zone. Puck picked off his stick. Great defensive play by Rick Oriold. As Team Canada East hoping for Oriold to have a stronger game here, and right now he's really strong on the puck. He's got to make a clean pass. He brings it all the way to the far corner. He's got Serbu heading to the net. Can't feed it to him. Blay was there as well, but now it's picked off by Chula. Chula tries to hit Dufour with the pass up the right wing, but that's picked off. And here goes Kelly Serbu through the neutral zone. Serbu, shielding the puck from the defender, carries it below the goal line, centered right there to Blay, but a terrific save by Weber, his first of the game as he keeps the left pad against the post.
That was a nice pass by Serbu, but Weber, again, holding close to that post on the left side with his pad down, kept the puck out of the net. Face off to the left of Weber.
Face off here with Serbu on the draw for the East. He can't win it against Juha. Good defensive play by Juha, banking it off the boards as it's on the stick of Kiefer Jones. Jones makes the pass to Brian Cowie just out of his reach as it's corralled by Wyatt Harvey. Harvey plays it around the far side. Sean Heslip digs it out as Serbu takes possession. He flips that one, hits Cowie in the bucket, but play continues on as Cowie now has possession for Team West. Good pass over to Kiefer Jones. There's the buzzer for the clean pass, but off the bench comes Richard to break up that chance. Held in now by Yuha. Yuha through the slot. Shoots! Oh, yeehaw, Yuha! What a beauty! 1-0 Team West.
Yuha moving freely in the center-ice zone into the slot. Lifts a high shot over the right shoulder of Cabral, and the Team West group have a 1-0 lead.
The pride of Rosslyn, Alberta does it again. Jason Yuha shows off some skill and some dash there, and he puts Team Canada West out front 1-0.
A superior skater. He really puts those blades on the ice and really, really covers a lot of territory very quickly.
Team Canada West right back at it. Great shot. Better save by Cabral as he takes it off the mask. The shot coming off the stick of Sean Dale.
Cabral adjusting the mask. He took that straight off the protection. He's taken it off and getting his thoughts about him, making sure everything is okay.
That puck really stings when you take it off the mask like that. Certainly Cabral earning a moment there to shake it off.
Play was whistled down immediately. Face off to the left of Cabral.
That'll be the case should the puck hit the goaltender in the mask at any point. Again, double IHF rules. Play whistled down immediately. Puck shot out across center ice as Kiefer Jones. Oh, we got a penalty coming up here against Alec Angus McKechnie as Wade Shepard doing a good job out there. And it'll be AMAC going to the box for the tripping call.
Guys, so, I just want to revisit that that goal by Jason Yuha. Once he hears that buzzer go, he just goes right to the middle of the ice. And there's basically no stopping him once he gets to the middle. So I think that's going to be the game plan, is just sort of trying to get things moving through him. That's exactly what they did. It's incredible.
Yeah, he has a great puck sense.
It's a really good point, Jeff. The danger factor with Yuha is not the initial rush, but once the pass is established, that's when he's at his most dangerous, because if he gets his puck on the stick, he can score from almost anywhere on the ice. Yuha wins the faceoff as Canada West have it on the power play. Makes the pass over to Jones, tries to feed it back to Yuha, but that's broken up by Oriold and shot down the ice.
And you could see with that pass, once the pass was completed, Yuha immediately went to the center portion of the ice, went to the slot looking for that return pass.
He's like a hunter. He circles until he's got the opportunity to strike as Kiefer Jones now carries it across center ice for Team West. Serbu back on the back check. Yuha receives the pass, cuts to the net, backhander right on, big save. The rebound, diving block by Wyatt Harvey, his second big block shot of the period.
Harvey sacrificing his body to stop that shot before it gets through to Cabral, and the Canada East clears the zone.
Here goes Canada West once again as Yuha brings it into the offensive zone on the left wing. He's got Chula with him. Oh, a tripping call coming against Chula. So that'll do it for the Canada West power play. We'll have a minute 08 of 4-on-4 hockey. As it is, interference is actually the call. Chula heading to the box.
He wasted no time. He knew as soon as the whistle blew that he was off for 2 minutes.
He thought he could get away with the pick there, but it gets called. Richard draws the penalty, and it'll be Simone Richard on the faceoff against Jason Yuha to the left of goaltender Lauren Weber. Team West win the draw. They flip it out across center ice. A foot race between Yuha and Oriold, and Yuha gets to it first, but he overskates it, and now Oriold takes possession. Del Grande receives the pass, dishes it off to Richard. His shot off the crossbar. Oh, so close to an equalizer.
Right off, square off the crossbar. The puck came right out. Weber was clearly beaten on the shot by Richard.
And a good play there by Richard to hold the blue line. He dumps it into the near corner. Wade Shepard first on it. Makes the pass to Jason Yuha. 30 seconds remaining in the Team East penalty, and then they'll have a abbreviated power play as Rick Oriold takes the puck across center ice. Oriold playing defense, but he does well to rush it up. Makes the pass to Serbu coming off the bench. Serbu back to Oriold. Just can't complete the last pass as it's now on the stick of Yuha. End of a shift. He's got to be tired. He just dumps it in, and he'll peel off for a change as Team Canada East just seconds away from a 53-second power play. It's now a power play for Canada East as Serbu dishes it right towards the goal, and Wyatt Harvey unable to get a stick to direct it past Weber.
Harvey just missed that perfect feed from Serbu.
Serbu, backhander, good save there by Weber. He had the angle covered perfectly. Puck shot out just past Wyatt Harvey and into the Canada East zone. 30 seconds remaining on the power play. Wyatt Harvey, feeling that urgency, head of steam. He rushes the puck up the left wing, runs into Kiefer Jones, gets the puck in deep. It's shot around the near side. Wyatt Harvey wanted, he's having a word with the official, but nothing coming out of that. 10 seconds remaining in the power play. Richard centers it in front. Fournazier has it in the far corner as he's challenged by Sean Dale, and Dale gets it past the defenseman, and that'll do it for the shortened power play.
I think Jones had position on that collision. I don't think he stepped into the East player. I don't think he had much of an argument.
Yeah, good no call there by the officials as Juha has the puck off his skates. Now it's on the stick of Simone Richard. He's got Mark DeMontis going up the left wing, but Richard has it poked away from him by Juha.
Nice defensive play by Juha.
Puck shot down inside the Canada West zone as that was Paul Schmold getting it outside of the line. Pokes it ahead. Juha takes a bit of a hit there from Rick Oriold. Battle for possession as Chula brings it into the Canada East defensive zone. 4:55 remaining in the first period of play. Puck across center ice as Paul Schmold takes possession for Canada West. Stripped away from him by Simone Richard. No other yellow jerseys in the zone yet for the clean pass as Richard maneuvers behind the goal. Plays it off the side of the goal, as that one was intended for Gary St. Denis, and now it's picked up by Jason Juha. Juha flips it up the right side to Martin Dufour, takes it into the corner, centers to the high slot. Scott Roberts makes the pass to Juha. He's checked closely. Juha's spinning away from a couple of checkers. Nice job by Wyatt Harvey to get the puck away cleanly. Can't quite clear the zone. Nice job by Canada West as they hold it in. Juha tries to center it in front, but it's flipped out to center ice where it's controlled by Kiefer Jones. 4 minutes left in the first.
Juha just looking for the puck all the time.
Martin Dufour tries the long shot. That's into the shin pads of Wyatt Harvey. As the puck cleared to the line, and Joseph Del Grande does well to backhand it to the stick of Kelly Serbu. Serbu flips it in. It trickles into the near corner where it's tracked down by Mark Bentz. Serbu takes it away from Bentzi. Serbu gets it back on the return. Shot right on. Good save by Weber. And then he sprawls out to cover the puck. Great goaltending from Lauren Weber.
And there's a pileup in front of Weber as the bodies scatter. But a quick backhand by Serbu almost finds its way to the back of the net. Really impressed with the play of Rick Oriole. He's a big man. He doesn't look like he's moving, but he covers a lot of space, both defensively and offensively. He has a very good puck sense.
It's interesting. Again, Oriole typically playing forward. He's quite skilled and has a great shot, but Paul Cairns using him on the blue line here. The puck stripped away from Oriole in this instance. Passed ahead to Chula. Great back check. Oh, off the crossbar and out of play. What an incredible sequence. And Chula, oh, so close to making it a 2-0 game.
Chula breaking in on his own was showing a lot of speed. Actually, I think that Cabral got the blocker on that shot.
Incredible. Joey Cabral making huge saves right now for Team Canada East as they trail 1-0.
Guys, I'm pretty sure Joey did get a blocker on that one. I didn't hear post at all.
A huge save there from Joey. I gotta start giving him more credit. You know, when I talk to him, he says he's the best goalie ever. Maybe he actually is. Great job by Joey Cabral in net for Team Canada East as Canada West bring the puck back into the zone. Chula tries to feed it to the far side wing. That's picked off by Richard and flipped out to center where Kiefer Jones plays it to the near side. Schmold loses his footing. Fournazier gets past Jones. He's got to make the pass, tries to flip it near side. That's picked off. Richard gets it now for the East. Smacking away for the puck in the skates of a few players, but now it's picked up by Heslip as he knocks it forward ahead to Chula. The Vancouver connection there as Anthony Chula brings the puck in. Tries to flip it near side, but that's picked off by Alec Angus McKechnie. Doesn't clear the zone, though. Nice play by Sean Dale. Chula with the puck behind the goal. The clean pass indicated. Dale tries to dig the puck out as Brian Cowie out there for Team West as well. Chula tracking it to the far corner against Oriold. And Team East do well to clear the danger. Fournazier with room to skate. He's got no clean pass yet. Wade Shepherd, beautiful back check by Shepherd as he lifts the stick and sweeps the puck away.
Fournazier with a little bit of theatrics as he goes down, trying to embellish the call.
Bit of a difference in bodies there as well.
Yes.
As you've got the veteran Wade Shepherd and the youngster Fournazier, and there's probably at least 200 pounds between them, if I'm guessing. As Wyatt Harvey takes the puck all the way back, or he tracks it all the way back to his far corner. A minute 35 remaining in the first. Bit of a risky pass, but it's a tape-to-tape one onto the stick of Kelly Serbu. Serbu has a trailer in DeMontis. DeMontis takes the shot, but who's there? It's Jason Juha making the play defensively for Team Canada West.
Juha deflecting that puck over top of the net, but it was a nice setup by Serbu to DeMontis.
Team Canada West get it out to center ice where it's picked up by DeMontis. He fires it back inside the West zone with 1:05 remaining here in the period. Kiefer Jones takes possession, slowly leads the breakout as we're inside the final minute of play here in the first. Jason Juha wheels back inside his own zone. Now he gains some momentum, bringing it into the offensive zone. Drops it to the near side for Scott Roberts, his shot off a shin pad, and now corralled by Juha in the near corner. Juha makes the pass out to Jones. Top of the far faceoff circle, his shot gets blocked. Team Canada East try clear it out, and a good job by Richard to get it down the ice. 30 seconds remaining. Del Grande receives the pass. Julian Blade tracks it to the near side hash marks, but some great end-to-end play by Juha broke up that chance.
Team Canada East trying to get that equalizer before the end of the period. Less than 20 seconds to go.
Team Canada East taking possession as Del Grande has it poked away from him. Richard gets it back under 10 seconds remaining. Tries to feed it to Del Grande. It's Blay who takes it. 3 seconds left as the puck in the corner. They try center it, but Chula breaks it up. And that does it for the first period of play. A great opening 12 minutes of action as Team Canada West with a 1-0 lead.
Lots of great end-to-end action by both of these teams. Some great scoring chances by Team West, but Joey Cabral up to the task, making a couple of very strong saves in that first period to keep it close. 1-0. It is Team Canada West leading Team Canada East after 12 minutes of play.
So, guys, we'll throw it back over to the boys from the neutral zone as the opening 20 minutes has Team Canada West up 1-0.
All right, thank you. Would help if I put my mic down, eh? Thank you, gentlemen. Great call in the first period. I'm joined by Cam Jenkins and Brett Wills. First of all, I just got to say, Chula was robbed in that period, boys. Do you agree? Either one of you.
Yeah, what more can you say about it?
Yeah.
I'm still, like, my jaw is still, you know, dropped to the floor when it comes to that. It's that, like, that was a beautiful period of hockey to watch. Like, that's the way hockey should be played. It was beautiful to watch.
Brett?
You know, it's funny. We watched Team Canada East play earlier, and I thought that for sure that they would be coming out and sluggish and whatnot, but they kept up with Team Canada West, and it certainly shows that Team Canada West has a little bit more energy with the 1-0 score. Jason Juha with the apple, but you know, we've been here before. We've seen Jason Juha play. We know what he's capable of, and
he comes to play every single shift,
and he's so fast. No matter if he's in the neutral zone,
good,
or if he's in the offensive zone, or if he's back checking, he is so fast.
He could be in the end zone and he'd still be doing a phenomenal job.
How do you defend this guy?
I don't know.
I'm literally
two or three players on him, maybe.
And I think that's the thing. Like, do you play man on him, or do you play zone on him? It's just, it's so complicated to figure out.
Do you just hope Cabral stops the puck when he, like...
And that's what you have to hope, too. And Cabral had a really good period. And, like, I can only imagine, without the one-pass rule, can you imagine what Juha would be doing right now?
Oh, I know. It's
how many times did he get across the blue line, and he was the only one there, and he had to wait for everyone to be able to come there to be able to join in the play?
We've talked about this on the neutral zone many a times. Guys can make their team look really, really good. And I'm not, no disrespect to anybody on the ice, but is this the case with Jason Juha, that he just makes everyone around him look really good? Because he's not only shooting the puck, but he's setting it up. He's making sure he knows where people are. Like, is this the case?
I don't know, Brock. I think that when you got a team of Anthony Sulia and Martin DeFour and Wade Shepard, as well as Jason Juha, you've got a team that it's filled with talent. So does Jason Juha make everybody around him better? Absolutely. But you know what? There's so much talent on that team. It's amazing that it's only 1-0.
And I think we really need to look at the X factor on Canada East, because every time Juha is on the ice, you see Simon Richard on the ice too. And he is a phenomenal player as well. And I'm not sure if it was him or not, but when it went off the crossbar and back out, you know, this game could easily be 1-1.
Yeah. And I honestly expected a much higher scoring period just because of the chances that came and came. Like, that was one of the best periods of hockey we have watched so far. Like, it was absolutely incredible.
Thanks so much. very delicate with that.
That's all right. I got my voice.
It's very delicate. Because if you go too hard, it's going to be...
Oh, I know, man. I got your thank you. You're welcome.
Okie dokie. Who are these guys anyway on this commercial? Oh, wow. Love you too, Nick.
Love you too, buddy.
Cool.
Hello, fans of the Mattamy Athletic Center here at Ryerson University. If you're just joining us, this is Team Canada East versus Team Canada West action.
Welcome back to AMI Audio Live's coverage of the 2019 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament. We're going to send it right over to our broadcast team, Nicole Cardarelli, to take it away for the second period action.
Thank you very much, guys. Second period underway here as Team Canada East in the yellow jerseys defending the zone down to our left have possession, trailing 1-0. Joseph Del Grande makes the drop pass. The shot attempt from Richard gets blocked. Del Grande tries to jam it home, but Lauren Weber covers it up. Good stop there for Weber.
Team Canada East storming the nets, looking to get that equalizer early in the second. Important for them to get that second goal to make sure that they get the momentum that they need to make this a hockey game. That was an excellent first period of play.
We'll give a couple shout-outs while we have the live chat up, including one to Joel Klug watching out in Connecticut. And, of course, a big shout-out to the Del Grande family as well. And a special shout-out to Pat Sheridan, who's tried to help us troubleshoot all the way from Vancouver. We apologize for any issues you may be experiencing. As here goes Anthony Chula with the puck up the right wing for Team Canada West. He's got Marty Dufour skating with him, Simone Richard all over his back, and a good job by Joseph Del Grande to force him to the corner. Chula with the puck behind the goal, near side, tried a potential wraparound, but that gets blocked. Nice play by Schmoll to hold it in at the line. There's the indicator for the clean pass, so it wouldn't have counted even if Chula had scored, as Kiefer Jones takes possession for Team West. Lead pass ahead to Chula. He's got Gilles Ouellette with him, tries to feed it through the high slot for Dufour, but that's picked off by the East as they play it off the glass. And now it's a 2-on-0 here for Team Canada East. DeMontis and Serbu. Serbu shoots, and he scores! Oh, no goal! Oh, my goodness. They're calling it off because the net was off. Oh, wow. Oh, my goodness.
That is a tough, tough break. Because that was a perfect setup by DeMontis to Serbu. And he picked the upper right-hand corner perfectly.
Well, and head coach for Team Canada East, Paul Cairns, is going to want an explanation. And I think what his case here is probably, even though the net's off, that's square down the middle. That's in whether the net's off or not.
I agree with you. That's a valid argument if that's the argument that he has. But the referee is not going to overturn that call. They're lining up for the faceoff in the west zone to the right of the goaltender Weber. That was an outstanding shot by Serbu.
Well, it was essentially perfect execution by DeMontis and Serbu on the 2-on-0, but some terrible luck for Team Canada East. And for the second time today, they've got a goal called back.
Jeff Ryman, did you hear anything down there in the discussion between the coach and the official? Obviously not.
Well, the chat room not too happy about that disallowed goal, but play continues on as Team Canada West still with a 1-0 lead here. Serbu tracks the puck inside his own zone. He'll wheel on the breakout. Tries to work his way up the right wing, but that's broken up by Jason Juha, whose stick explodes on him. And this could be a chance. Serbu! Oh, what a save by Lauren Weber as he kicks out to make that stop.
Quick reaction from Weber to keep that puck out of the net, flashing the pad and keeping the puck out.
Juha with a new stick. He makes the drop pass. That shot attempt knocked down by Serbu as he flips it over to the far side hash marks.
Good defense by Serbu to stop that shot from getting to the net.
End of a shift. He dumps it in from the wrong side of center, but he gets a good roll as the puck stays in, as now Wade Shepherd makes the pass to Juha up the left wing. Juha drops that one back and quickly gets it inside the zone as he's defended closely by Gary St. Denis. Over to the far corner where Simone Richard does well to strip the puck away from Juha.
Nice play by Richard to come up with that puck in the defensive zone. And here he goes.
He's got some lane to skate. He gets tripped up, and that'll be a penalty as Paul Schmold will take a seat in the box for two or less as Team Canada East coming up with a power play.
Simone Richard with the puck heading up the right wing was tripped up by the West player, and that's good enough for 2 minutes for tripping.
Let's give a shout out to Ryan Juha from back in Rosland as he's watching his brother Jason, and a shout out to Debbie from Aurelia who's cheering on members of the Ice Owls. You know what's incredible about Jason, and his brother Ryan mentions it, Jason still regularly plays sighted hockey. And he dominates most of the time as well. He is one heck of a player.
That's terrific.
But here, his team is on the PK as Alec Angus McKechnie moves the puck around. Cycles, makes the pass to Richard. He shoots and rips that one just wide of the near post. Fournazier tries to dig it away, but it's Kiefer Jones who comes up with it. Jones, under pressure, banks it off the boards and up to Chula. Anthony Chula dumps it in deep as it rolls all the way behind the Team Canada East goal. 8:45 left in the second period, a minute 25 left in the power play.
Guys, a little side note here. Jason Juha actually went back to the locker room, picked up a brand new stick. He didn't like the stick he was using after he snapped his other stick. So he said, you know what? I'm just going to go back to the locker room and get my third stick.
Well, he's got a new stick on top of the new stick, and here he goes with the puck. Jason Juha tries the drop pass shorthanded. That one picked off by Fournazier. And now a potential 3-on-1 for Team Canada East. Good hustle back by Kiefer Jones to get a stick on that centering pass as Roberts rips it around the far boards. 50 seconds remaining in the power play. Sean Dale knocks it down the ice. A foot race here as Julien Blais gets to the puck first. Richard, at the end of a shift, he'll just dump it in deep and peel off for a change. And that'll give Wade Shepherd a chance to lead Canada West here out.
Not too many chances for Canada East to get this power play going.
As here's a potential shorthanded break for Canada West. Centered in front. Oh, what a save by Cabral. And he makes a second save on Dufour as well. As it was Juha putting it on a tee for Marty Dufour. But two huge saves from Cabral.
Cabral in the right place at the right time. That's the second massive save that he has made in this game to keep Canada East in it.
5 seconds left in their power play. That'll do it as Juha gets the puck out through the neutral zone. Blais touches it offside. There's still 1 second left in the penalty, but a great kill there from Canada West.
Joey Cabral living up to his self-moniker as the greatest goaltender ever.
You know what? We had lunch a couple days before the tournament, and I gave him a hard time because he's a huge Maple Leafs fan, but he was telling me his favorite NHL player ever was Patrick Waugh. I said, buddy, how's it not Felix the Cat? I know they're not the same caliber of goaltender, but come on. Oh, he's playing like Patrick Waugh right now, making save after save. And he's a big reason why it's just 1-0 for Team Canada West. Richard keeps the puck in at the far blue line, feeds it down low into the corner. As they try to dig it back out front, nothing doing yet. DeMontis gets it,
Oh,
runs into his own man and takes away that chance. Oh, great play by Richard to hold the line and keep the play onside. It's DeMontis trying to get away from Chula, ends up centering it, and it's picked off here by Canada West. Heslip moves the puck up the ice. Chula takes control. as he works it down into the corner. He cycles over to the far side inside the Canada East territory. Picked off by Richard. 6.5 minutes remaining in the second period. 1-0 the score for Canada West as they put the puck back in deep.
You know, I'm surprised that the score is so low. It's only 1-0 for the West with the quality of play that we've seen so far. This goaltending has been outstanding.
I think that's a big part of it. Both goaltenders have brought their A game here tonight. Both of them making some spectacular stops as Canada West try break out along the far boards. They get it to center ice where Frankie Beauregard dumps it right back in as Wade Shepherd takes control. Shepherd wisely takes his time on the breakout here. Bates Serbu in deep and then moves it past him as Canada West flip it to the far side boards, but Beauregard right there again hammering it back inside Canada West territory. Teams exchanging puck possession. Julien Blais dumps it in. Delayed offside, Serbu had to wheel out. Now he gets, well, he had possession, but it's stripped away from him and shot down the ice down to our left. 5:25 remaining in the second period. Julien Blais wheels out from behind the goal. Bank pass to Fournazier. They still have possession as Blais picks up the trailing puck. Oh, he gets cleaned out there by Kiefer Jones. That's an easy penalty call as Jones extending the arms. And that'll be a roughing call against the Calgary native.
Got the stick up around Fournazier's face and took him down heavily.
So Canada East will head back to the power play. They couldn't generate much with their last man advantage, but they'll be trying to change that here as they send out Simone Richard, Alec Angus McKechnie, Joseph Del Grande, and then two typical forwards playing the blue line as it's Rick Oriold and Mark DeMontis on the point.
Keith Jones getting 2 minutes for holding.
Puck bouncing around, West cleared out to center.
Could have been for attempted strangulation. He did a pretty good number on him.
You know, he's a Calgary boy. I think he's always been a wrestling fan. That was a pretty good clothesline there.
Those Calgarians, they like to play rough.
DeMontis skating it out here for Canada East. 30 seconds already gone on the power play. But DeMontis, head of steam, tries to center it in front. Juha makes the pay defensively. Richard plays it back to the point. There's the clean pass. Fed in front for Alec Angus McKechnie, who rips it just wide of the near post.
High slot, and he just missed the right side of the left side of the net.
Juha skating up the near side wing, dumps the puck in deep with 1:05 left here on the Canada East power play. They shoot the puck out to center, where it's corralled by Joseph Del Grande in front of his own bench. Poked off his stick, Canada East hammer it right back out. Kelly Serbu coming off the bench as he tries to track that loose puck. Serbu does well, feeds it over to Fournazier. Fournazier back to Serbu, shot right on. Oh, two huge saves by Weber as he covers the ice perfectly.
Serbu was left alone. He got the initial shot that was stopped by Weber, and then he got his rebound. And again, Weber covered up to keep the puck out, to keep the score 1-0 for the West.
Tremendous goaltending here from both Lorne Weber and Joey Cabral, but right now Lorne Weber making some crucial saves to keep his team up 1-0 as we've got 3:59 left in the second period of play. Referees having a quick discussion here before they drop the puck. That gives the Canada players on both sides a chance to have a quick discussion here as Kelly Serbu and Jason Juha No doubt, imparting some knowledge on each other there.
Actually finding out where the beer's the coldest after the game.
Your room, my room, where are we going here? That's probably more accurate, yeah. The two will square off for the face-off. Serbu wins it to the hash marks, but quickly cleared down the ice. Scott Roberts racing after it. Great hustle from Wyatt Harvey to get there first. You know, Wyatt Harvey has impressed me so much. Year after year, he just keeps getting better and better. And this is maybe the best hockey he's ever played.
Just a tremendous skater, showing a lot of speed and hustle to get back to that puck.
Wayne St. Denis makes a good play to keep the puck in the zone. 18 seconds left on the man advantage. Julien Blais tries to wrap it in front. That one gets knocked away from Fournazier. And here goes Team Canada West shorthanded. Juha, he's got Chula with him, makes the pass. Chula tries to sweep it back to Juha. He's got Roberts there. Yeehaw shoots, and he scores! Yeehaw, yeehaw! It's 2-0 for Canada West as Jake the Snake gets his second of the game.
He took the puck around the net and held it, froze the defense. The goaltender was out of position, and he found the far corner.
That's what makes him so dangerous. Once that pass gets established, there were two passing options in the slot for Yeehaw, but as you mentioned, Jim, he holds it, and he holds it, and he holds it a little bit longer before eventually sniping one to make it 2-0.
That's confidence.
Yeah. So Canada East now in a hole here. They came back against Team USA earlier today. Can they get another comeback? Here goes DeMontis. Shoots, and he scores! Oh, what a response from Team Canada East as they get a quick strike. Mark DeMontis puts them on the board after a beauty setup from Richard.
Richard gets the line and makes a quick pass to DeMontis, who was set free in alone in the slot, and he puts it through the five hole of Weber to get Canada East back in this game. It's now 2-1, and lots of hockey left to play.
And let's remember that DeMontis was a part of that goal that was called back earlier, so some redemption there for Team Canada East and Mark DeMontis as they're now within one. Striking just seconds after Team West go up 2-0. Puck inside the Team Canada East zone. Jason Yeehaw feeds it down low behind the goal into the near side corner. DeMontis rims it back around to the far side. Kiefer Jones steps in from the point. His shot attempt from the half wall gets knocked down by Rick Oriold as he flips that across center. Nice job by Richard. He tracks it. Richard with possession for Canada East. He's got a player parked in front, but the stick tied up, so Richard just cycles out top. We got one excited fan over here. As Richard makes a good play there to keep the puck in the zone. Oh, what a block by Paul Schmold as he dives to get a piece of that shot from Richard. Canada West try cleared along the near boards. Good job by Gilles Ouellette to get it down the ice with 2:15 remaining in the period.
That goal has given the East a lot of momentum. They're starting to take the play to the West now, looking for that equalizer.
They've got some mojo here, and let's see if they can keep it going as Joseph Del Grande rims it to the near side, and Julien Blais tries to hold the zone. Blais battling there against his Hibou teammate Ouellette, and it's Ouellette that gets the better of that sequence. Canada East put it back inside the West zone. If it has enough, they'll call it icing, and they do with a minute 48 left in the period.
All of a sudden, the ice is tilting towards the Western net as the East starts to put the pressure on. That goal by DeMontis has really given them a spark. West continues to lead 2-1.
We've got a scoring change on the Team West goal. Apparently, it was Anthony Chula who scored, so maybe he deflected the shot from Yeehaw. But as it stands, it's Chula who gets the go-ahead goal, and DeMontis are striking back for Team East to get them back within one. Chula with the puck in the far corner has it poked off his stick by Beauregard, played back to the line where it's kept in by Shepard. A rolling puck, can't get settled down by Chula, and now Fournassier takes it across center. Good pass to Serbu. Serbu takes the shot, rips that just wide of the near post. Far side hash marks. Nice play by Oriol to keep it in, but just as quickly it's fired down the ice. A foot race here between Roberts and Serbu. Serbu with the crafty play to lift the stick as he takes the puck up the middle of the ice now. 1:05 left in the period. Serbu drops it to Fournassier. His shot, good block there by Wade Shepard as he pins it up against the end boards. Referees tell him play the puck. It's pinned under him. Serbu wanting a call, and he's going to earn the penalty here as Shepard just throws his stick away. But, oh, that's some undisciplined play by Wade Shepard to take that penalty.
He was told to move the puck. He didn't do it, and he's going to pay the price.
He's going to shake his head. He'll still be smiling, though, that's for sure. Nothing takes the smile off Wade's face. But he's put his team in a tough spot now on the penalty kill with a one-goal lead and 52.4 seconds left in the period.
So the East will finish the second period with a power play and start the third with a power play unless they score.
Well, and that's not out of the realm of possibility given the players that Coach Paul Cairns has put out there. He's got Simone Richard on the draw. Joe Fernazier will be playing the right wing. Kelly Serbu on the left. Wyatt Harvey and Mark DeMontis on the point. But once again, Team Canada West, on the strength of Jason Juha, win the faceoff and clear the puck down the ice. DeMontis wheeling out of his own zone. 39 seconds left in the period. Brings it across center, dumps it in deep to the far corner. Jones blew a tire, and it's now picked up by Juha, and he'll clear that down the length of the ice with 25 seconds remaining in the period. Wyatt Harvey tracks it to the near corner, chips it ahead as it's controlled by Richard. He dumps it off to Serbu. Serbu across center ice, 13 seconds left in the frame. Serbu driving wide, trying to cut to the goal. Harvey pinching in from the point. 7 seconds remaining here. Serbu makes the pass near side. Harvey receives it. His shot goes off a shin pad and behind the goal. And the buzzer sounds. Some great action to end the period. But it will end with Canada West up 2-1 over Canada East.
Canada East putting on the pressure on the power play to end that period. Came up with a couple of close chances, but ran out of time. So the score remains 2-1, the team's trading goals in that second period. So the West has the advantage going into the final 12 minutes of play.
Canada East will start the third period with 1:08 left on the power play and a chance to equalize. But they trail heading into the third period, although it seems like they've got some momentum on their side going forward. For more intermission analysis, let's send it back to Cam, Brock, Brett, and hey, even Jeff down at ringside, the boys from the neutral zone in AMI.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. All right, guys, I know that when there's a goal denied, we can't change it, but we're asked to give it analysis, so was it a good goal? Was it not?
I'm not 100% sure. I didn't get a great look at it. The net may have been off.
My eyes aren't what they used to be. So sitting up here in the heavens of the old Maple Leaf Gardens, it was a little bit hard to see. This is my 2 cents worth.
Nobody wants to go out on the limb and say whether it's a good goal or not. Come on, people.
Well, Brock, was it a good goal or not?
I think it was a good goal.
Oh. Way to put your neck out on the line.
Yeah. You guys didn't join me, so, you know, that's my prediction. All right, so we saw Canada West get out to a 2-0 lead, a goal from Anthony Chula, and then almost right away, Canada East replied with Mark DeMontis' goal. Gentlemen, if they didn't reply right away, could this game have been over, Brett?
I think you could say that it could have been over, but you got to give credit where credit is due. Mark DeMontis, he is a beast. He is a warrior. He is no quit. He, in my opinion, he's the heart and soul of this Team Canada East.
Cam?
Yeah, and what can you say about DeMontis? Last game, he got absolutely rocked. I think he took a shift, maybe two shifts off, and now he's back, and he's doing DeMontis-type things. So, but Canada West, you know, they hung in there. My prediction is, as far as Canada East losing their legs, that certainly doesn't seem to be happening. They seem to be, at least in that period, skating circles around the Canada West team.
And you know what? I need to apologize or get something off my chest, because I thought that this match between Joe Cabral and Lauren Weber was going to be one where Joe Cabral was going to be the guy that everybody was watching, because I thought personally he was the better goaltender. But Lauren Weber has really impressed me. From watching him last year to watching him this year, just absolutely night and day.
Yeah, I think Cabral is trying to get Nico Cardarelli to define him as the best goalie in the world. This guy has just stepped out. I agree about Lauren Weber as well. But man, goaltending has just been the story, guys. Why do we think this is?
I think at the end of the day, it's the competition is so great here, and it is so quick, so fast. And you just get some games where the goalies, they're the MVPs, and that's what's happening in this game so far. They're making, you know, fantastic save after phenomenal save.
Yeah, no, it's you're absolutely correct. The other thing that I noticed is there's been a lot of penalties in this whole tournament, in the two games you've watched. Mm-hmm. Why is this?
You know, I go back to the experience that I had on the ice, and I think maybe they're holding their sticks a little bit too tight. They're afraid to make some mistakes, and mm-hmm. when they're afraid to make mistakes, they end up making more mistakes, and it costs them in terms of penalties. So.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's been a pretty tough game. You know, for a game that's supposed to not have hitting, it seems, or it doesn't seem, there is a lot of hitting, especially with, who was it, Kiefer Jones. He had an absolute monster hit on somebody. He ended up having to go to the penalty box because of that. You know, they're going to have to stop the chippiness, and they're going to have to stop the big hits, and I think that's one way that they're going to stop going to the penalty box.
Yeah, it's just nuts how much... And it's not just incidental contact either. It's
full on
contact. We're going to go ringside with Jeff Ryman as he's got an interview with Anthony Chula.
I'm standing here with Team Canada West forward Anthony Chula, and you scored that second goal. Did you get a piece of that? I didn't realize.
Somehow tipped it. Lucky bounce, I guess. Either way, we scored. That's what matters. Doesn't matter who got it.
Yeah, and this is also the first game of the tournament for you guys. You already know that Team Canada East won earlier today. I asked Mark DeMontis this question earlier. Canada East versus Canada West. I know you guys would probably really like to be playing together as a whole, as a team, going against the Team USA. But is this for bragging rights here a little bit?
Oh, definitely. There's a little bit of chirping going on in the ice, and I think everyone wants to come out on top, and more importantly, wants to make a good impression to the management staff ahead of summer camp. So it's a really good pace out there. Yeah.
And one last question before I let you go. You're in Toronto. You're from out west. Any big plans for the big city of Toronto tonight?
Get some sleep.
Are you sure?
Probably.
Pretty serious about this. I like it. Thanks so much, Anthony.
Thank you.
I love the honesty there of the get some sleep. On that note, we're going to take a break right here on AMI Audio Live. We are covering the 2019 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament. Stay with us for third period action and more analysis right after this.
Okay, let's go 2 minutes.
Somebody's playing the hip. Courage.
Mark, will there virtually be no time at the end of the game?
I don't know if it's a hard out or not. Let's wait till Andy comes back. Because we're done at... It's supposed to be done at 7:30. Well,
yeah, that's
8 o'clock.
Yeah.
I guess we'll have to bring it to like a half hour probably.
Yeah, I would think so.
Probably go to 8:30.
Can you put this one over my ear? It's a little... Thank you. Thank you, sir. You're good.
Better?
Yep, that's the side I can't get to because this is the bad end. Thank you.
Don't ever say I don't do anything for you.
Oh, I won't.
You never do anything for me.
Oh, I know. I don't, and I don't ever want to do anything for you, Cameron.
That's not very nice.
Brock Cameron needs a hug.
I'm not giving him a hug.
Hi, Nick.
I want a little bit of quick thoughts on the game plan for period three. Maybe. Yep. You're awesome, Nick. Welcome back to AMI Audio's live coverage of the 2019 Canadian Blind Hockey Championships. I am joined by Brett and Cam. Gentlemen, we're about to get ready for the third period. What is the game plan?
Game plan for Team Canada West is just keep playing their game. You're going to make a couple of mistakes, but if you keep playing the way you're playing, keep the pedal down, you're going to end up winning.
Cam?
Yeah, as far as Canada East, they seem to be going stiletto high clips, so let's see if they can keep this going for the third period. I think they had a lot of good opportunities in the second period, a lot more than the West did, and let's see if they can pull this out.
Yeah, I believe Mark DeMontis gave Canada East the legs that they may need to get through this third period. I'm looking forward to a really great third period, and hopefully we can see a little less penalties and a little more five-on-five play, because we've seen a lot of that. I'm really looking forward to five-on-five play. And I just love the ringside interviews that we're getting. It's been great. With that, we're going to send it back to Nico Cardarelli and the broadcast team. Guys, take it away.
Guys, thank you very much. Great job by the Neutral Zone crew. And we're so happy to have AMI on board once again as a presenting sponsor. As you're tuned in to the 2019 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament, we're streaming to you live from the former Maple Leaf Gardens. And we've got a barn burner of a game going on here heading into the third period. It's Team Canada East trailing Team Canada West by a score of 2-1, but Team Canada East will start this third period with a minute 8 remaining on the power play.
Critical for them to get off to a big start. The goal that they scored in that second period gave them momentum, and they started to take the play to the West, but they ran out of time, obviously, and now it's a chance for them to pick up where they left off and get that equalizer.
Well, Team Canada East ready. They're on the ice. Team Canada West hasn't even come out of the locker rooms yet, so maybe a little bit of extra strategy being talked by the Team Canada West coaching staff, consisting of head coach Jeff Street and the assistant coaches Joey Alley and Sean Cowie, as I'm sure they're trying to figure out how to defend this lead for the final 12 minutes.
Jeff, what's the attitude of the East as they came onto the ice?
I was just going to say, they're pretty loose. Joey and the coaching staff were having a good laugh at something, so they're pretty loose right now, and I think that's a good thing coming into this third period. They're down 2-1. They need a goal, and it'll be fun to see how they come out, because they had a pretty good finish to that second period. I thought they really started to find their legs, especially Mark DeMontis, who seemed to really carry things from the back end. As of course we've alluded to, he scored that first and only goal for Team Canada East, and I wonder how crucial that no goal will actually be coming into this third period.
What was the reaction on the bench, Jeff, when that goal was disallowed?
I think it was a little bit of shock. I don't think they realized that it was no goal. Even for me, I didn't really know. And then the ref came over, talked to the coach, and said the net was off before they even got into the zone. So I think Team Canada East was a little bit surprised by that, and I think they're a little bit disappointed and upset. I mean, they have every right to be, because they were arguing, why wouldn't there have been a whistle beforehand? Why didn't they whistle it dead while, well before they had that 2-1-0 break? So a little bit of disappointment, but it's nice to see how they came out, and they finished the period strong, so I wonder if that momentum will ride into period number three.
It has to ride into the third period for them if they want to make a hockey game of it. It's only 2-1. It's a one-goal game, and 12 minutes to go.
Your coaching staff for Team Canada East, consisting of Paul Cairns, Wade Del Grande, and Joe Cowboy McCallion, as we get you set for the third period of play. Team Canada East, Team Canada West. The puck is dropped, and we're underway as Scott Roberts knocks that one down out of midair. Bringing up the right wing, the drop pass intended for Chula. That gets picked off. Puck played to the near side corner. 55 seconds remaining on the Team Canada East power play. Simone Richard digs it off the wall, tries to advance it up to Serbu, but that's picked off by Mark Bentz. As the puck knocked down by Serbu, he brings it across the blue line. Draw pass to Richard. Richard takes the shot, and he scores! Just 32 seconds into the period, Team Canada East tie it on the power play, and Simone Richard finds pay dirt with that shot.
That goal actually started at the blue line with the smart play by Serbu to slow things down and to deliberately wait for his teammates to catch up to him as they crossed the line. It was a 3-on-1, a perfect pass from Serbu to Richard, and he finds the top corner. Tie game.
Well, that didn't take him very long, and maybe that speaks to the swagger and the kind of looseness that they had on the bench. They were feeling confident, and they tie the game early here in the third. And now Joe Fournassier picks up the puck as he brings it inside the Canada West zone. Dumping it down behind the goal, picked up by Julien Blais. He works along the near side hash marks, plays it back to the point for Wyatt Harvey. His shot attempt knocked down by Gilles Ouellette as it's played out to center ice. Bit of a tie up there between Serbu and Harvey. Harvey taking a bit of a knock, and he had some choice words for the official about the no call. Marty Dufour plays the puck off the near side boards and inside the east zone. Wyatt Harvey tries to smack it out. It's pinned down by Gilles Ouellette and played over to the far side corner where it's corralled by Kelly Serbu. Serbu dumps the puck in, but Wade Shepherd knocks it down. Shepherd fires it back inside Canada East territory as the team's just exchanging puck possession at the moment.
Canada East with the jump right now.
As Ouellette works it up the left wing, he's got Juha parked in front. Three yellow jerseys converging to intercept that pass. Wyatt Harvey, he's got some room to skate here along the wing. Pokes it forward a little bit out of his reach. And now Canada West able to knock it out past center ice. Gary St. Denis, nice job to out-muscle Jason Juha on that play as it's corralled by Wade Shepherd. 9:55 to go in the third period. If we're tied, we will go to overtime. We'll have a 5-minute 4-on-4 overtime. And if we're still tied, then we'll go to double IHF rules shootout. So five shooters, and then after the first five, you can select the same shooter over and over again. As Team Canada West try work it out here. Anthony Chula, he's pinned up along the near boards. Nice job by Wayne St. Denis, who was featured in a publication recently as part of Bob McKenzie's Hockey Heroes book. As Heslip's shot into the near corner, Chula has it behind the goal, poked away from him by Simone Richard. Richard banks it off the boards, not out initially. Good second effort there by Gary St. Denis to clear it down the ice.
Complete line change for Team Canada. East.
Just going to say, which one? It's like, I don't know if you remember when the NHL changed their all-star format. They went to the world against North America.
Right.
And Harry Neal at one point said, the world is changing. And that line has always stuck out with me. It's just a good laugh. Anyways, as Team Canada West banked the puck out. Nice work there by Heslip to get it down the length of the ice. Don't think it's going to have enough for icing. Oh, it just crosses the line, so we'll get a whistle with 8:28 left in the third.
Harry Neal, what a character he was when he was doing hockey. He saved my life in New York at Madison Square Garden one night.
Come on.
We used to do the intermission segments in the Zamboni area where the Zamboni came on and off the ice.
Okay.
And the two of us were standing there. I was had my back to the ice. He was facing the ice.
Uh-huh.
And he kept on looking over my shoulder as we were talking. All of a sudden, he grabbed me, pulled me aside. He said, look out. And the Zamboni came flying through. I said, Harry, you just saved my life.
Oh, that's incredible. shot from the point off the stick of Alec Angus McKechnie gets knocked down by Jason Juha. As Scott Roberts corrals it, makes the pass into Juha, tries to tuck it home, but Cabral had the net covered perfectly. Serbu wrestles it away from Juha, and then he'll send that down the length of the ice.
Juha tried to go low on Cabral, but he had that corner covered, and Juha just couldn't get the puck up, and the score remains tied at two.
Rick Oriold feeds it off the boards to the near side wing, intended for Julien Blais, but Juha comes in and separates that play. Juha receives the pass from Roberts on the wrong side of the blue line, so no clean pass. Ooh, Serbu gets dumped there. A bit of an awkward collision with Paul Schmold. No call. Play continues on.
Serbu talking to the referee as he leaves the ice.
Well, we've seen some calls for less as Rick Oriold ends up crashing awkwardly into the boards in front of the Team Canada West bench, but he pops back up and he seems to be okay. Julien Blais with the puck near side hash marks. Takes it down low into the corner. Makes the pass to Simone Richard. He gets hammered off the puck there by Gilles Ouellette as those two have a bit of a word. And now it's Richard who brings it back into the zone, but he didn't realize Blais was offside. So we get a whistle with 7 left in the third.
They're having a little chat down on the blue line. I got you this time, but I'll get you next time.
Well, those two players have skated a lot over the past year, both members of Les Bleus de Montréal's program and a big part of their program and on the bench throughout the weekend here, Robert Gignac. As there's a shot from Richard, DeMontis buries the rebound and a sweet celly there from DeMontis, whether he meant it or not. He sprawls out as he puts his team up 3-2.
Simone Richard, the man on that play, kept the puck in the west zone and took the shot. The rebound came to DeMontis, and he slid it under the sprawled goaltender Weber, and the East has now taken the lead 3-2. These are the comeback kings. They were trailing the United States before they came alive, and now they have scored 2 unanswered goals to take the lead.
He's the man of a million nicknames. You may know him as Mark John. You may know him as Demo, but Mark DeMontis puts his team back in front here 3-2.
Timeout called by the West.
Timeout, Team West. Team West is called.
Discussion going on at center ice. I believe that's Kelly Serbu complaining about the non-call when he was taken out of the play. Well, maybe not.
Well, he's certainly,
yes, it is,
stating a case for something. Yeah, Serbu.
Yeah, he's not too happy. He's gotten taken out a couple of times throughout the game, I think in all 3 periods, actually, and he's been pretty upset, so he's been talking to the refs.
The West trying to gather their composure after the East has come back with 2 very, very quick goals to not only tie but to take the lead in the third period. Again, as we mentioned earlier, this would be a huge win for the East. They've already got a victory under their belts against Team USA. So this would put them in great shape in this round-robin segment.
Team Canada East will be back in action tomorrow night at 6 p.m. Eastern as they get set to take on Team USA once again. And Team Canada West will play at 11 o'clock a.m. Eastern. But yes, a potential huge 3 points on the line here for Team Canada East now that they lead 3-2. 6:45 remaining here in the third period of play as they move the puck up the right wing into the zone. Serbu receives the pass, tries to drive towards the goal. Nice job by Kiefer Jones to stand tall, and eventually crashed into his goaltender, but he stopped Serbu from driving to the net there.
The net eventually comes off its mooring, so the play is blown dead. But hard work by Serbu driving to the net, looking for that insurance marker for the East. Should mention that both of those games are on AMI tomorrow as well.
And again, we're so thrilled to have AMI here at the 2019 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament as one of our 2 presenting sponsors, one of our 2 presenting partners, and it's so great to have the whole crew on board here, from Andy Frank to Mark Aflalo, everybody behind the scenes at AMI doing a great job. Serbu with the puck, takes it off the post. Far side, Joseph Del Grande can't quite jam it home.
close play by Serbu. He had lots of time to get that puck away, and he had the spot picked. He wanted to go top corner, but he got the post instead.
Anthony Trullo with it here as he goes across center for Team Canada West. Tries to split the D. Rick Oriold sniffs that play out as Serbu has it poked away from him by Wade Shepherd. They try center it in front for Shepherd, who's getting a shift up at forward now. And that's good because, well, he was pretty good up there at Westerns alongside Jason Juha. Puck back inside the Team West zone as that's Mark Bent smacking it out across center ice. Picked up now by Joe Fernassier. He brings it into the zone. Tries to drop it over to Richard. That pass gets picked off. Trullo leads it up to Juha. Back to Trullo, who gives it to Juha. Nice play to bring it into the zone. They still have to make a clean pass in the zone, but Wyatt Harvey does well to strip it away and then clear it across center.
That's why you don't see, if a guy's going in on a breakaway, you won't see him take a shot because he has to get that clean pass away. So if they're going in on a one-on-one or a breakaway, they're always looking for the trailer to make sure they get that clean pass before they can take a shot.
Richard with the puck in the far corner tries to lift it out. Kiefer Jones does well to pinch in from the point and hold the line, but seconds later it's shot inside the West zone. Mark Bentz first on it for Team West. 4:55 remaining in the third period. They've got to find some go now that they're trailing 3-2. Juha, he can't get it past. I think that was Serbu there. Yeah, good play by Serbu to hold the line as Harvey gets it inside the blue line. Wyatt Harvey's shot from the line goes over to the far corner where it's Jason Juha banking it off the glass but not past Alec Angus McKechnie. Big play there. Serbu takes a shot. Good block by Mark Bentz. And now a chance for Jason Juha to wheel up the lane. Heslip makes the pass to Juha. Heslip going towards the net. The yellow jersey's picking up the trailer. Juha still nearly fed that pass through a sea of three yellow jerseys. Shot down the ice. It's not going to have enough for icing, so Paul Schmold tracks back with 4:05 left here in regulation.
Enough time for Team Canada East to make a complete change, get fresh legs out there.
As Anthony Trullo makes the pass near side for Scott Roberts. Roberts returns it to Trullo. Trullo nearly tripped up, continues on, tries to feed it in front. Where is it? It's in the far corner. Kiefer Jones makes the pass to Trullo. He tries to cycle out to the high slot. Drop pass to Jones at the right point. Kiefer plays it off the boards down into the far corner where DeMontis, battling there against Trullo, makes a good defensive play with 3.5 minutes remaining in the third period. Richard gets dumped up. That's going to be a penalty. Scott Roberts doesn't like the call, but he's headed to the box for two or less.
You know, Oriold is, I think, right now is the unsung hero of this East team for the play he just made in front of Cabral. It looked like the West was going to have a great chance, but Oriold was there and cleared the puck and actually helped Cabral make a big save to keep the puck out of the net and retain the lead.
3:26 remaining in the third period of play. Team Canada East leading 3-2, and they're headed to the power play here as Scott Roberts, the Vancouver native, in the box. Getting some great comments on the chat thread. Let's give a shout out to Nathbo, to Audrey, to the Del Grande family, and Jason cheering on Team West from Roslyn. Serbu wins the faceoff. Back to the point for Wyatt Harvey. His shot gets blocked by Jason Juha.
Juha just getting down on all fours and blocking that shot to clear the zone.
Potential shorthanded break here as Wade Shepherd makes the pass over to Juha. Juha trying to work his way up front. Lets the shot go. Wyatt Harvey gets his body on that. They still dig away. What a save by Cabral. Second chance. The net comes off its pegs. And we'll get a stoppage and... Well, they were sort of pointing at the defenseman who took the net off, but I don't think anything more is coming out of that, just the stoppage in play.
The West starting to play with a little desperation, less than 3 minutes to go. They need that goal to tie it up and hopefully force overtime, but Cabral standing tall in that net again, coming up with a big save when necessary.
Cabral has brought his A game, just as Lauren Weber has as well for Team Canada West. It's a goaltending duel, and if not for those two keepers, it would be a higher scoreline. But it remains 3-2 for Team Canada East as Jason Juha nearly with an equalizer there, although I don't think the clean pass had been made yet. Now it's made. Juha takes it at the top of the circles, checked well by the youngster Fournassier, and now they're able to clear the zone as Julien Blais streaks after that loose puck. Makes the pass to Fournassier, gets around the defender, tries to flip it on goal, but Shepherd there to get his body in the way of that shot. Juha, Fournassier, and Shepherd battling for the puck. It's Shepherd who flips it out front to Juha. 53 seconds remaining on the Canada East power play, 2:15 remaining in the third period. Oh, a penalty coming here to Rick Oriold as he laid the body on Chula going into the zone. So that'll do it for the East power play, and Team West catching a break here with 2:09 left to play.
Well, Oriold going to the box. Let's hope the hero doesn't turn into a goat.
He's a gritty player, and he definitely disagrees with that call. Tough sequence there as he really didn't have any space to react, but he gets ticketed for the body contact, and we'll have 44 seconds of 4-on-4 hockey before Team West get a power play. 2 minutes for body checking. Body checking the call against Rick Oriels.
Of course, there is no checking allowed in blind hockey, but there is bodily contact. You can't avoid it. But you can't purposely set out to take somebody out.
Just like women's hockey, and the CWHL is having their awards banquet here in this facility tonight. And a big shout out to that league, and we pay homage to them here at this tournament with our youth teams being named after the Toronto Furies and the Markham Thunder. But here go Team Canada West as they bring the puck into the zone. Paul Schmold tries to feed it over to Juha. That's broken up. Kelly Servu tracks it, and a potential break here. Servu's got Fournassier with him. Makes the pass, shot right on. Oh, a huge save from Weber, and bookmark that if Canada West can equalize.
What a great save by Weber, just timing that save perfectly as the perfect setup by Servu.
As he brings the puck back into the zone for Canada East, he's got Wyatt Harvey as an option, as well as Fournassier. Harvey shoots off the mask. Play continues on as that shot attempt then gets blocked. Canada West now on the power play. Oh, Weber dives across and makes another save. Crucial stop with a minute 11 left in the third.
What great pressure by Canada East on Canada West, but Weber coming up tall. Just three or four fabulous saves to keep the puck out of the net and stay within one goal. Time running out, just a minute 11 left to go in the third period. The East leading the West 3-2.
And the West now on the power play for the next minute three as Juha gets set to take the defensive zone draw. A rare loss there by Juha, but they still get the puck out of the zone as they lead the break up the right wing. Chula has it poked away from him by Wyatt Harvey, who continues to impress defensively.
Great defensive play by Harvey right at the blue line to take that pass away and keep it out of the zone.
Final minute of play. Pass just off the stick of Juha. Controlled here by Wade Shepherd. Passed over to Gilles Ouellette. Top of the faceoff circle. Over to the far faceoff dot. Juha tries to get an open shooting lane. Nothing doing yet. 40 seconds remaining. Wade Shepherd makes the pass to Scott Roberts. Near side faceoff dot. Roberts fires one. A big block as they try clear it. Richard shoots it down the ice. It's not going to have enough for icing. And with just 25 seconds remaining, Team West have really got to get some urgency here.
Cabral with a big save with the blocker as they clear the zone.
Scott Roberts. Draw pass intended for Juha. Broken up by Richard. Juha tracks it once again. No clean pass yet. 10 seconds left. That's going to do it. Fournassier skates it up out of the box. Comes Oriold. A chance to bury it. And he does!
With 1.6 seconds left.
Well, the Toronto Ice Owls connection ices this game for Team Canada East as the youngster sets up the veteran. Oriold finishes it off, and it's 4-2.
What a killer. Oriold out of the box, taking a perfect feed and going top shelf to make it a 4-2 hockey game as time runs out. That is it. What a big, huge win for the East.
You can't get a much more exciting finish than that. End-to-end action. Team West may be feeling a little hard done by that they couldn't close this out, but full credit to Team Canada East. They battle back from a 2-0 deficit, have one goal called back, and they still find a way to win this game 4-2.
A great hockey game for Team East. Very well played at both ends of the ice. I thought the West was just tremendous. The way they started, I thought that Team Canada East was really going to have their hands full, and they did. I mean, there was some great end-to-end action throughout the course of this match, and for Team Canada East to come out on top, it's especially playing their second Team game of the day, is really credit to them.
So Team Canada East start perfect here on day number one of the 2019 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament. They take both of their games, coming back in both games for the victory, as Team USA and Team Canada West will face off in a big matchup tomorrow at 11 a.m. Both teams hungry for their first win of the tournament. Well, Jim, I got to say, it's been a real pleasure working with you here today. I can't thank you enough for coming out and being a part of the broadcast.
Thank you very much, Nico. It has been an absolute pleasure for me. I have loved today. These two games that I saw have opened a whole new appreciation for me, not only for the sport of hockey, but for blind hockey as well. The quality of play that I've seen here today is just outstanding, and you did a great job, and thanks for carrying me with you.
Oh, thank you very much. Anytime you want to come ride shotgun with us, anytime you want to come to blind hockey, you are more than welcome. You're a friend of the program, so
Absolutely.
Thank you for being here
thank
today.
Thank you so much.
Well, the teams shake hands, and that'll do it for the action on the ice, wrapping up day number one at the 2019 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament. To wrap everything up, let's send it back to the boys from the neutral zone and AMI, who have done a great job all day long. Boys, take it away.
Thank you, Nico and Jim. Well, boys, what can you say? Really good game, really good end to the game. 4-2 victory. What are the thoughts as we close off today?
You know, this just proves that you have to play 48 minutes, sorry, not 48 minutes, but 36 minutes of hockey from start to finish.